Most techniques we learned up to now to solve differential equations require integrations. Many functions, though, do not have an antiderivative, which means that it is impossible to find an explicit analytic solution. In this video, we'll encounter a different method which does not require integration. We assume that our solution can be written as a power series, and we will try to determine the coefficients of the power series and thus the solution of our differential equation. How does that work? That's what you will learn in this video. So the idea is that we will write the solution of our differential equation y of x as a power series. Suppose our initial conditions is at x equals 0, then we'll expand around x equals 0 in a power series, sum n from 0 to infinity, cn x to the power n. The idea is that we want to find our coefficients, c0, c1, c2, etc. So that's our task. Use the differential equation and the initial condition to solve for c0, c1, etc. for all the infinitely many coefficients. So how does it work? Let us take some very easy examples first. So divide the x equals 1 and y0 equals 2. I know you can solve this directly by integration, but just to illustrate how the method works. So we plug in y equals c0 plus c1 times x, etc. Now first, using the initial condition, y0 equals 2, we find c0 equals 2, because if you plug in x equals 0, all the higher order terms here, they all cancel out, they all zero out, and we're only left with c0, which has to be equal to y0 equals 2. So now we have already our first coefficient, c0 equals 2. What about all the others? Well, for that we use our differential equation. First we compute y prime, so c0 drops out and we get a c1 plus c2 times x plus c3 times x squared, etc. And our differential equation tells us that the value of x has to be equal to 1. So this power series has to be equal to 1 plus 0 times x plus 0 times x squared, etc., etc. So if we compare left and right hand sides, we first compare all constants, so we observe c1 has to be equal to 1. Then we compare all terms with x's, so 2c2 times x, there are no x's here, so 2c2 equals 0. Then the terms with x squared, c3 times x squared, no x squared here, so also 0. So you see all the other cn's are all 0, so c1 equals 1, and c2 up to cn, all of them are 0. So then we summarize, we have our series solutions as c0 plus c1 times x, and all the others are 0, so y of x equals 2 plus x. Of course, you could find this by direct integration as well. Now you see how the method works. Use initial condition and then use differential equation to find all your coefficients cn. Second example, y prime equals y and y0 equals 1. Again, we see we have an initial condition at x equals 0, so we make a power series around x equals 0, c0 plus c1x plus c2x squared, etc., etc. And first of all, we can use the initial condition, y0 equals 1. If you plug in x equals 0, everything drops out, and you only have your c0 left, so no, y0 equals c0 equals 1. So that gives you the c0. Next steps, use the differential equation. So here we have our y, and then we differentiate. We get a c1 plus 2 times c2 times x plus 3 times c3 times x squared plus 4 times c4 times x to the power 3, etc., etc. That gives you your y prime. And then our differential equation says y prime equals y. So we have to compare the constants in y and y prime. So c0 equals c1. c0 equals 1, so c1 is also equal to 1. Then c1 equals 2 times c2, so 2 times c2 equals c1, so c2 equals 1/2, because c1 equals 1. Then c2 equals 3 times c3, so that allows us to solve for c3, because 3 times c3 equals c2 equals 1/2, so c3 equals 1/6, and we go on. c3 equals 4 times c4, so c4 equals 1/4 times c3 equals 1/24. And so you see already what's going on. Y equals 1 plus x, x squared over 2, x cubed over 6, x to the power 4/24. And the next one would be 1 over 5 times 1 over 24, and then the next one 1 over 6 times 1 over 5 times 1 over 24, etc., etc. So you recognize the pattern now for the Cn. You can even prove the pattern, of course. Cn behave like 1 over n factorial, so your total solution would be sum n from 0 to infinity x to the power n over n factorial equals e to the power x. So also, if you have an infinite number of non-zero coefficients, still can use this method, because you sometimes can recognize the pattern in the Cn.